Remy Wolf, big jump, take one.
Hi, I'm Remy Wolf, and this is a documentary about my song, Liz. Okay, so we went to my friend Robin's dead grandpa's house. We went with me, Jared, my brother Lucas, Danny, Julian, oh, and Gideon and Chloe. There was a lot of people. Gideon was like juggling the whole weekend or whatever. It was the first time any of my friends from Los Angeles had ever met Jared.
I don't know if I was drunk. No, I wasn't drunk. She was drunk. I was high.
But it's not very often you meet someone like Jared.
Because you're so beautiful and cute.
Which I think was quite a shock for a lot of them.
Remy was like, let's go to San Diego. That's where all my friends are going to be. We should just go there. And I was like, okay, I thought we were going to riot.
Go! Remy, you got to tilt it up.
We literally were drinking beers all day for like 4 days straight.
You know, I set up in the little room.
And he would complain all the time about how the house was way too small for his body.
But it was very small. And my family is like, you know, we're tall people.
Hello, Amp.
Liz came down. Liz was only there for one night.
The sun was setting. You know, I just like grabbed Liz and I was just like, Liz, 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 Liz.
Liz and I met in an audition. We ended up going to USC together. We have an interesting history. I feel like we're always annoyed with each other, especially when we were living together. We did not do well living together. We definitely have a sibling vibe. Like, I feel like she's definitely my sister because we've gone through so much together.
We were just so sloppy.
Yeah, I think I was pretty fucked up.
And then eventually, like, I just started going like,
see a sexy little mama, like a daddy daughter.
So I was feeling really good about Liz that night, and she was loving it. So I wrote Liz, Liz, she taught me how to live. She taught me how to give. That was also kind of a joke, too. And actually, in Liz, the background vocal is saying, shoo, shut up.
She's a sexy little mama.
There was, like, literally no intention with it at all.
Don't seem the same. Since she working on the corner.
I think we wrote all of that weekend. So that was kind of like a story about like a really sad sex worker. Yeah, okay, so that was like how Liz started. But then it was still just a song that was like strictly just me and Jared. There was no recording of it. We could play it live, and we did a lot.
She's a sexy little
we didn't end up actually recording any of it until this trip that we took to the UK.
Be like, okay, let me check my iPad.
March of 2020. And we decided that it would be fun if we tried to just get into a studio. And it was weird because COVID was like active, but nobody like really knew what was going on with it.
We're recording a song called Liz.
It's a song we've had for a while.
It was something that Jared and I had never done. We had never like been to like a nice, nice recording studio ever in our lives. A
lot of pressure when you're in a big analog studio. Because you're under, you know, a time limit.
I didn't feel the nerves of it. And I don't think Jared did either, because I feel like when we both go into something together, we both have this like strange confidence that we don't have when we're apart. But like when we're together, we're just like, okay, we're just gonna do this and it's gonna be fine.
That sounds good.
I'm gonna do with it and then stop. Because it sounds weird if I cut it off and don't do the.
Right.
There's so much gear everywhere and there's just so many choices. But I remember being exhausted because of the time change. The London time change really fucked us up. Except Connor. Connor's fine. He's always fine. So fucking upsetting.
Adam and JL, who are these two lovely men that I know, they recorded guitar and keys. We had a really fun time with them. The mixing engineer's name was Jamie.
He looked just like Paul McCartney.
We don't say we're kidding.
Yeah,
just,
yeah.
If you get it, you get it.
You just don't.
I thought he was like Paul McCartney's son or some shit. You know, we were in London. Could have been. Wasn't.
Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Bye now, I'm going down, 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 down.
It was honestly strange. I think I was in a weird place mentally. My whole life was kind of like changing under my feet, and I was just like confused. And I just thought that was hilarious.
Remy recorded her vocals.
I was like, okay, let's just get like a nice take. But I like wasn't feeling great.
It just wasn't, she was so exhausted. It was hard for her to sing. And then I said the worst thing, AKA the best thing possible, which was,
hey Remy, what do you think about just maybe running some scales? Maybe we could just run some scales together?
Everybody was shocked after I said that, even myself.
It sounded so condescending. I was like, fuck you, Jared.
She was so pissed, she took out the anger on her next take.
It was my angry vocal take, and that was the vocal take we ended up using.
She don't eat alone, she goes home alone tonight.
You know what you should do, though? You should practice some skills. Yeah.
Why did you say you want to do some skate? Why did you say that? I'm like, I don't fucking know. Like, warm up a little bit, motherfucker. Shit.
Jared will say something and it pisses me off, and then like, I do better. And that happens a lot. Actually. And then after that, we got back from the UK and the whole world was shut down.
This coronavirus thing is really happening.
And that's kind of why Liz, I think, took a pause.
That was kind of it for like a year.
We just finished it a couple weeks ago in East West Studios. Juno peed everywhere. I love the song. I feel like I'm referencing a lot of Amy's sound, Amy Winehouse. When I thought about what type of artist I wanted to be, I was always like, I want to sound like Amy. I don't think my shit really sounds like Amy at all, but like, this was my little nod to her. The mentality when I wrote Liz was much more of like, let's go drink and have fun. I had no idea what the hell I was doing or who I was as a person.
So embarrassing.
Put that on YouTube.
Oh my.
And I was drinking then too. I've been sober for like 8 months now. So I think that's also like shifted a lot of things. So now I'm actually just like sitting with my feelings, and it's such a different experience, which I think maybe a lot of people realized earlier that like every day is different. But that's like a new thing for me. There's just a lot of learning. I'm just learning a lot.